each year, especially we admire, respect. I'm sorry to say this, but we call classical information processing. Because in our community, we say quantum information processing and quantum classical information processing, but we even call the deductive theory as classical. So it's just the classification. And also I'm very interested in post-quantum cryptography. And how do you prove that the backward calculation is impossible even using quantum computers? And we don't know how to prove. We know some kind of quantum cryptography is secure by using quantum mechanics. And sometimes, for instance, if you have said this is our product, quantum cryptography terminal, so please use this. Do you believe this? That's another problem in quantum cryptography. And there are advanced versions of quantum cryptography so that you don't care about this machine. Just looking at data between Alice and Bob. And if it violates the Bell inequality, then the communication is set, regardless of who made this. But of course, there are more primitive types of quantum cryptography you need to believe. And such kind of quantum cryptography is already, people test level. And here I put a public key cryptography, which is conventional, and quantum computing, and quantum cryptography, and post-quantum cryptography. And so, the realization of quantum computing is a threat to public key cryptography. And this is revealed theoretically in 1994 by Peter Shor. And then, it is revealed that quantum cryptography is secure, even though quantum computing attack against. And then this is a kind of solution for this threat. And this is clarified in 1997. However, the assumption is your machines or devices are complete. Thank you. For instance, if I say this is thin photon generator, then push this button, then with probability 1, single photon is emitted. No two photons or three photons. In that case, the eavesdropper can extract single photon, two photons or three photons. And so, gradually, we adopt more practical cases so that this machine is not an ideal photon generator. And also detectors, we use good detector, photon counter, but still the quantum efficiency is less than 95. Of course, the best one is much better, but it's not 100%. And sometimes, even though no photon counts, it takes. So that we call dark counts, and that is very, very annoying. And also there is time jitter. So if there is time jitter in the detector, you need to open the window of counts. And we incorporated that kind of practicality, and gradually, in that case, some kind of cryptography secure. So we can publish many papers by gradually changing conditions from ideal case to truck many devices. But anyway, another solution is of course post-quantum cryptography. So in a sense, this is an alternative to quantum cryptography. And of course, this is a threat to quantum cryptography. Why? Because implementation is easy. So now, I remember in 2000, year 2000, a researcher called Sergey is famous among your community. So he suggested about the post-quantum cryptography, and they didn't use that word. But of course, the encryption is easy by using classical computers, but decryption is difficult even using quantum computers. But for a long time, I hear no progress in that area. So gradually, I think, okay, such kind of cryptography is not so easy. But very recently, maybe 2 or 3 years or more, I don't know, but some kind of lattice quantum cryptography is said to be such kind of quantum cryptography. And this shows my research side, starting from undergraduate to becoming a professor emeritus. And then, after the master course, I joined NTT, and for 7 years, I did research on optical fiber communication. But from this 1985, so I changed my field into quantum. So how to reduce quantum noise reduction? So my stance is quantum noise is something evil. We need to separate. But after that, I stayed in Essex University in England with Professor Rodney Loudon. And then I met David Deutsch, Arthur Eckhart, and Charles Bennett. And then I was baptized by their theory. So quantum noise is not an evil thing, but we can utilize that for many things like quantum cryptography or quantum computing. So Charles Bennett proposed BBH4 in 1984. And then next year, David Deutsch considered about quantum Turing machine. And at that time, his conclusion was a quantum Turing machine is not advantageous over classical Turing machine. However, Richard Josa insisted, no, you are wrong. Quantum machine is superior over classical machine. And they wrote a paper after I returned to Japan. And so I knew about quantum computing before their paper, so I'm a little bit doubtful about quantum computing because no proof. However, I decided to do something about quantum cryptography. And then Peter Shor, as you know, Peter Shor proposed how to crack calculate factorization and discrete law in 1994. And immediately after that, do you know Katsuragi Okamoto? Is he famous? Okay. So he immediately called me over phone. And is it true that he proved that quantum computers can do factorization? organization very efficiently, and that is really awful thing, he said. And nobody came, I got many phone calls, and my answer is to say, that's true. However, quantum computers will be realized maybe 50 years later. So 50 years later, around here. But I started to write many papers on nature communication. So this is the first conference or symposium named Quantum Computation Cryptography in 1993. Here you can see David Deutsch and Charlie Bennett, many of I think Maurer from Switzerland is the only classical cryptography person. Maurer from Switzerland. And there is only one person who is not a European or American. So he looks like this. And our slogan is information is physical. Information is not something written on paper or on the memory, but it is physics. But David Deutsch is even more interesting thing. He says physics is information. So starting from information theory, maybe someday one can reduce or quantum theory. And that kind of research is really interesting. And so anyway, so and this is the first symposium. And the latest one is Japan EU workshop on quantum technology, which was held in September, the beginning of September, in Sorbonne University. And here I gave a talk about my recent study, frequency conversion of single photons emitted from atom ion quantum memory for telecommunications. And this looks like really something material that I have. But we use many linear algebra too. And so at that conference, some United States people listened to lectures, and then last month there were three visitors from US, and one of the three knows everything, and he asked me, what do you think about post-quantum cryptography? And then I asked back, do you think that United States quit physical implementation of quantum cryptography? And then he answered, no. So, yeah, because we have this conversation. We know that in the US, quantum cryptography research is getting a little bit underground, and it's difficult to get information from there. And I think, I don't know the answer, no, but maybe US believe in quantum cryptography in the end. That's my guessing. Even though post-quantum cryptography, of course they could use that. But still, in parallel, they continue this research. And there is a concept of expiration date of secrets. And for instance, entrance examination, so this is highly secret. So we are very nervous about discussing, making the problems. And then I put them in somewhere I can look. But the expiration date is the date of examination. And after that, it's no problem, no secrets. In that case, you don't need to use quantum cryptography, but RSA is enough because before the expiration date, there is no chance that quantum computers are realized. So, in this case, no problem. But for instance, some kind of diplomatic secret, US president sometimes reveals 20 years old or 50 years old secret. And that means the secret today, this kind of secret today, will be revealed, for instance, 50 years later. In that case, maybe quantum computers are realized, practical quantum computers. And maybe before that. And in that case, some kind of hacker can eavesdrop everything, even though he or she cannot decipher them. Anyway, collect the encrypted ciphers. And then once there is some method to decipher them, then all in at once they are revealed. So that is scary. And maybe I should ask what kind of people secrets very long term. I don't know. For instance, private letters. I don't know. For instance, I like music and I sometimes read Chopin's letter, private letters. Very important, from very important one to very stupid ones. And so nobody cares about Chopin's privacy at all. So that's because he is a genius. But anyway, in this case, if there is a very long-term secret, then we need to use highly secure cryptography right now. Because, as I said, the hacker collects every cipher. And then once there is a way to decipher them, then all of them are revealed. And so, what I am doing, maybe I can explain some kind of what is the quantum information processing by explaining my own field. First of all, why necessary? And what are the problems? And then how did we deal with these problems? And how are we going to cope with these problems? And is there any alternatives? And usually, I don't explain about this, but for instance, there are many different kinds of alternatives, I mean. So, post-quantum cryptography is one kind. And if you want to use a quantum cryptography for very long-haul transmission systems, then you need so-called quantum repeaters. Do you know repeaters? Repeaters is already, classical repeaters are already used in the world. For example, between the US and Japan, there is an undersea cable. and there are many repeaters to discriminate whether the signal is zero or one. And then before they disappear, then again one or the zero signal is created by a strobe laser. That kind of system is embedded in every, I don't know, 20 kilometers from Japan to the US. That is a quantum cryptography. So what is difficult is you should not discriminate whether the signal is zero or one, because we use the superposition of zero and one, or sometimes we use entanglement with somewhere qubit. So if that qubit is zero, this qubit is one. If that qubit is one, this qubit is zero. And in that kind of case, we call it entanglement. And in that case, you shouldn't discriminate zero or one. That destroys everything. And there are some alternatives. Okay, there are common sense tells that you need quantum memories to realize quantum repeat. But recently, my students wrote some paper after graduating my room, and then he joined this kind of project. But his alternative is, without using quantum memories, quantum repeaters is possible. And so, starting from why necessary, maybe in January this year, this is a Japanese newspaper and about the Chinese quantum cryptography via their satellite called Misius. Misius is a name of a Chinese old philosopher. Maybe Confucius is very famous. Misius might be not so famous, but Misius is also a great philosopher. And his name is put on this satellite. This is made by Chinese and launched by Chinese. And so this orbit is not a same orbit, but a kind of GPS-like. And so it goes around the Earth. And when this comes over Beijing, and then they exchange private keys by quantum cryptography. That is full quantum cryptography, not a fake at all. And then several days later, this goes around the Earth, and then this comes over the Austria. And then they start to exchange private key. Of course, in quantum cryptography, a private key is not sent and received, but it is created during quantum communication randomly. That means this key and this key are totally different random number table. Then this satellite can send this random number table using this key over time. So this key is already used, but this key is sent to China. Then that means they share this key. So they can do some kind of one-time part. Then the distance is very large, but using this method, they can communicate using quantumly created classical key. However, one thing we know, or they know, or they the compound virtual community node is that it takes several days from China to Austria by rounding the earth. And during that period, the classical keys are stored in this satellite. And then someone can hack that. I don't know who is somehow. Russia or America, but anyway. I don't know. But anyway, so if this can keep the quantum information for several days, then their key is full quantum. This key is full quantum. This key is full quantum. But this information is classical, so it is not so safe. We assume that this is a well secure, but this we don't assume that this is secure. So anyway, in this sense, so long distance quantum break is anyway necessary. So this is Chirikov Regulator's paper they wrote. So this is some numerical data they put on this digital letters. And then, anyway, I persuade people who need to do something. But what I'm doing is not a satellite. Okay, so it's not a cryptography, but in Japan, optical fibers. So, based on optical fiber quantum control. And so, what are the problems? There are two main big problems. One is transmission loss and noise. And noise for the Q-ring can be described by Pauli operators, Pauli matrix. And even the transmission loss can be expressed by these matrix. But first, I would like to explain what is the problem of transmission. And I skip the former. But just okay. For instance, Delft University successfully shared entanglement between 1.3 kilometer per quick point using energy sensor, nitrogen vacancy sensor in diode. And maximum did 21 meter separating. Using this wavelength, using rubidium atoms. And the problem here is this is visible light, this is visible light. And for visible light, maybe you heard about the optical fiber loss. For telecom wavelengths, the optical fiber loss is decreased, not so rapidly, but for visible light. The same optical fiber shows a very stringent decrease in loss. So, for instance, if you want to do 300 kilometers of communication, okay, here is the dark count of the detectors. And under this, we cannot distinguish whether it is because of dark count or signal. So we need to quit this. So 300 kilometer transmission is possible by using telecom wavelengths, but for visible light only 20 kilometers. So it's too short. So that means I go back to the previous identity. They cannot increase this 21 meters or 1.3 kilometers. More than 20 kilometers. So, we need to solve this problem.
And
this is transformation of the process. The third problem is this is our collective experiment that we did nearly 20 years ago. This is an optical parametric conversion, and we can create an entanglement with whose fidelity is nearly 100%. And however, if we put this photon into an optical fiber, then the optical fiber has noise rather than loss, and that noise is a phase noise. Electromagnetic wave phase, and that destroys entanglement. And so here we obtain 100% of this photon at this point. Therefore, now we put this photon, then the fidelity goes down to 50%. 50% means no entanglement. If fidelity goes 0%, that is anti-correlation. That means if someone answers for yes no question, always the opposite answer, then you can use that person as an oracle. And if he says yes, okay, then the real answer is no. So we observe 50% fidelity after putting this photon into the optical fiber. Actually, this is experiment, so this is not exactly 50%, but 46%, but close. And then, anyway, this is the problem. However, we continuing this problem, solve this problem. And first I would like to explain what the decoherence-free substrate is. Before explaining that, there is a quantum error correction. I wonder if I need to explain about quantum error correction problem. No, I don't know. Oh, okay. Then, so error correction code, like a Hamming code, we use in compared to this daily life. But the problem is, as I said, you shouldn't look into whether where is the noise by counting 0 or 1 explicitly. Without discriminating 0 or 1, you should do where is the noise, which qubit suffers from. And assume that n physical qubits are used for encoding one logical qubit. Then the dimension of the filament space becomes 2 to the n. And you can utilize 2 to the n. But half of them, only half of them you can utilize to find the noise, allocate the noise. And which kind of noise I mean? Which of the three Pauli matrices? And that means total, there are three different Pauli matrices. And you use n real qubits. So there are possibility of 3n cases. And of course, plus one case is not matching superposition between 0 and 1. That means, so this should be larger than this. So this is inequality. And the smallest number which satisfies this is 5. So at least you need 5 photons to encode single qubit. And that means, maybe I skip. There is a, this is a, how to realize high qubit, high real qubit. The important thing here I want to explain is this is a really clever idea, and I was really astonished seeing this. This is a 5-qubit case, but the famous one is 7-qubit, which is called the Steen code, and 9-qubit is called Peter Schoen code. But anyway, at least 5 photons. That means, so this T is transmissivity of single photons. So if this is 0.01, which corresponds to 100 kilometers, that means it is really small number. So this is infractional at all. But we can reduce that 5 qubits into 2 by using the clear free substitute. So this is qubit 1, qubit A and B, and this oscillates, 2 qubits oscillates like a photons oscillator of every way. So in phase. And so the noise is applied to this qubit A and B. Say exactly the same. And in that case, although the phase itself is changed, but the change is the same, the in phase is in phase, and then out of phase comes out of phase. So then we can rename the qubit bases 0 and 1. For instance, physically in phase corresponds to computational 0, and out of phase corresponds to computationally 1 state. And then we can use this system. So, for instance, this is a qubit you have given to you, and this is the Ancira qubit or reference qubit you can prepare. And then this has a 2-dimensional Hilbert space. This has 4-dimensional Hilbert space. So you encode this information without discriminating 0 and 1 into this coherence-free subspace. Then, even though there is a noise, that means a refractive index change, it doesn't feel this noise, as I explained. And then, the rest of the thing is decode this. And we did this experiment for the first time, and it was even we did we create entangled 2 photons, and we put this into our coherence free subspace. And then we observe this entanglement is kept untouched. And so, skip the data, but so we didn't use real fiber, potential phase noise, which we use by liquid crystal modulators, we didn't use optical fiber. But anyway, this is the first achievement. So it was, the theory was published in Physical Review A, but the experiment was published in Nature. And then next, we used 10 meter fiber. So natural phase noise we suppressed. And then we increased the length of the fiber to 55 meters. Now, so this is good that the number 5 is reduced to 2 because other than the signal, we only need reference. So the transmissivity suffered only square of transmissivity. However, the question is, can we reduce this 2 into 1? You cannot reduce less than 1. And the answer is surprisingly yes. And we did this experiment and comparing our previous experiment, which shows the T2 square, and the new result shows the T itself, transmissivity itself. And the next work we did, okay, this is about 3 achievements that suffered from square, 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 but finally we did the transmissivity itself. Next work we did is, I didn't explain explicitly, but what we suppressed is only the phase noise. So only one of the Pauli modulators. And finally, last year, we succeeded in suppressing phase, polarization noise, or both. So, 3 Pauli modulators are all suppressed by our method. So, it's a really step by step process. And so, since I don't have enough time, maybe I just here is we need to change the photon color from visible light to telephone wave without touching the antenna. And this is the difference frequency generator module. And the color is changed here, but the quantum information is untouched. The idea is superposition is kept, but color is changed. Or entanglement is kept, but color is changed. And we did this experiment. Skip the details. And important thing here is we use, I'm very sorry that we have some photos of this superconducting single photon detector, which was developed by NICT people, but maybe it's safe to skip this. It's just a... And then, this is how we do this kind of statement. And then, anyway, this is how we delve in. And then our plan is to realize quantum repeaters, but not within our first of three years project, but one part of the quantum repeater. I mean, and this is the very important geograph of quantum repeater. Here, for instance, this is Suica campus, and maybe this is in Nagoya University. So far, maybe 50 kilometers or 100 kilometers, anyway, something like that. And this is quantum memories. And this photon is emitted from this quantum memory. So this and this are entangled. The photon cannot, we cannot stop photon, so it goes with speed of light to this. And this photon comes from this. And then if we measure this photon and this photon simultaneously, this is interesting. Simultaneously, you measure the state of two photons without watching into single photons individually. That we can do. In classical sense, it is the same. So to measure each photon individually, and then we conclude that the two photon state is this one. But in quantum mechanics, we can do two photon state measurement without touching each photon. And when this is called Bell state measure. And when you do this, then suddenly, originally independent, this memory and this memory becomes an entanglement. This is very strange. So we call this entanglement swapping. So in this way, we can create entanglement between this memory and this memory, which are located at the state. And we plan to do this, the same thing. And unfortunately, this is a stochastical process. So there is only some probability we success. So the first round is unsuccessful. Second one is unsuccessful. So the third one is successful. And here, only fourth one is successful. Then, if we discard all of these